We have with us our eminent guest for today, Mr. Saurabh Prasoon. He is design head in Jani Mumbai, a pass out from NIFT Mumbai. Saurabh has been associated with Union Jani Limited for more than 11 years now. Correct me if I'm wrong, Saurabh.
No, yeah, you are right only.
Heading the design department, I think, for more than 9 years now.
And yes.
We have the major crowd among attendees who are from various fashion colleges. I think, I'm sure today's session is going to be extremely significant for them. So now I pass on the screen to Saurabh. Saurabh, we can guide our attendees further.
So, yeah, good morning, guys. And hope you will be, you are able to see the, you know, main screen.
Yes, yes.
Shweta, I'm okay?
Yes, all good.
Yeah, okay. So let me start with what has happened and what is the current scenario of the fashion industry. So which is having a big time impact on, you know, globally. And this presentation will be having two parts. Firstly, what are the challenges as a, you know, fashion industry? What are the challenges we are facing right now? And number two, what will be the plan of action? How can we evolve from here? How can we go back to normal? So this, I have planned this session in, you know, the entire session in two parts. And the first part, it will be around 40-45 minute session. And then after that, we can have the question answers.
Okay, attendees, whosoever have any questions, please type in your questions through the question and answer box right at the bottom of the screen. And anybody who faces any technical clinch can please give your queries on the chat box. All right, we'll be happy to help you. Thank you. Yes, Saurabh, please continue.
So the current scenario, if we talk about, is like, if you can see the first slide. So this is the, the current scenario of the earth right now. The mask is everywhere. It has become the, you know, current fashion all around. And people have to wear it, not because they have to keep themselves safe, but also their family. So, yeah, this has come because of this. You must be knowing about the coronavirus. Everybody is talking day, night, every time about the same thing. So, yeah, so this is the new thing which has now occurred, and it has imposed a lot of challenges also. And so everybody is having a different perspective to how to tackle it. Every industry is going through a lot of highs and lows, and I'll be talking about the fashion industry. So the current situation is, fashion industry has come to a standstill due to the corona crisis. So you all must be knowing that there is no, you know, shops, malls, standalone shops, the, you know, lifestyle shoppers, everything is closed right now. And nobody is thinking of ordering any, you know, garments for themselves, because it is not falling into their essentials. So everything is at a standstill, and people do not know that what will happen to the fashion industry. Now, the worst part is that world fashion capital like Milan, Madrid, Spain, you know, Paris, New York, who drives the fashion industry across the globe, are the, you know, most hit capitals, you can say, or the countries, you can say, from this corona crisis. So the numbers are high. The, you know, fortunately the deaths are also there. So, and a lot of, you know, business balance, everything has gone for a toss. So if you will see that only these five cities or these five countries, some of the most popular brands are from these countries only. So like Gucci, Diesel, which is the very, very premium brand, which is from Italy. Zara, like all the, you know, Indian metros are having the Zara stores right now. And it is the brand from Spain. Louis Vuitton, which is a very top segment brand. It is from France. Nike, Abercrombie, which is from USA. And next, Superdry, the United Kingdom. So what we can see that not only the premium brands, but also the sports brands are highly affected due to this crisis. And it is going to have a long lasting impact, because nobody knows that everybody is trying hard how to get business, how to drive the situation in a better way. But right now, the situation in India also, if you see the cases of this, numbers are increasing, the corona patients are increasing, and they really don't know that when will it stop, when will the complete lockdown will get over. So, and like I'm from Mumbai, I'm right now in Mumbai, and Mumbai, you know, it is like the worst hit city in India. The cases are like, you know, there are like around 2000 cases every day happening over here. And most of the industries, fashion industry, is located in Mumbai only. Mumbai is the hub, you can say that. So people, I keep talking to different, you know, my friends who are working in this fashion industry and textile industry, and they are really worried. Okay, so I'll be covering all the points, and these are the challenging points. But yeah, there will be some hope, and we'll talk about the same also. So now you can see this. I have shared, you know, that visual image in which you can see that the world is hit by corona pandemic, and you can see that like people are wearing masks, and even all the countries. So this has become the new trend, and every country and each individual across the globe is affected due to this. Okay. Now what has happened more is, Shweta, is it okay? Like I'll just keep checking it.
Yeah, it's okay. Fine. It's fine. Perfectly fine.
Yeah. Okay. So the world events that drive the fashion are either cancelled or postponed. So, for example, Olympics were scheduled to happen this year. And you know that all these, you know, big events drive the fashion industry, like IPL in India, which has, we do not know that will it happen or will it not happen. A lot of runway shows are not happening this time. Now, Premier Vision is a very big fashion fair, which happens in Paris every year. So that also didn't happen. So these are all the things that are having a lot of impact on the current fashion. Okay. Now, one more thing. The world leading countries have started to boycott China. China is a big hub, manufacturers and exporters for fabrics, fabric trims, accessories, and garments. So if I'll tell you in percentage, around 45% of, you know, fashion industry is driven by China, directly or indirectly. More than that. So because they are making a lot of, you know, new stuff. People go there. They are offering them the garments also. They are giving them the trims. Trims are very important, which makes the, you know, garments like the buttons or the rivets or, you know, the new heat transfer stickers or something. So, and a lot of, you know, sports brands are also looking into the, looking into the China market. But pandemic has arose from China, and people do not know that they are in a you know mix that means maybe China is a force behind this pandemic, and all the business are not working properly. So they in a way have started to boycott China, and Donald Trump, you must be listening to him also. He is very vocal about this. He China is the main culprit and whatever. So somehow this, when the raw materials and like the garments was like exported from China, and now it has come to a standstill. So it is going to affect the fashion business. So that's why China's, from the China perspective, it is a backseat. Okay. Now retail business is affected a lot. Online and offline business has come to a standstill. Like e-com was on hold, and the shops are still closed in like red zones and green zones. They are having alternate options that one day this shop will open, next day that shop will open. The workforce, which is the backbone of fashion and fashion, are migrating from the industry. So a lot of, you know, workers, like fashion business is not driven only by, you know, the whoever is in front. A lot of, you know, there is a backbone, laborers that stitch the garment, that make the garments, that do the printing work, that do the washing work. So they, that also has been hit in this time. Okay. Now the virtual is the new reality. The large scale occasions like festivals and wedding are happening, and relatives are taking part virtually. So what has happened, like today is Eid. Eid Mubarak, everyone. And that also we are doing on this virtual thing. So which has now become the new reality. And you can imagine that a lot of shopping used to happen when these festivals occur. you know, ETH was a different level, business for a lot of people. But they are not doing their business right now, and that has been hampered. Now, if I talk about weddings, so India was known for their lavish weddings. A lot of designers was there into it, making lavish garments and everything. But now wedding is not happening. Wedding season has gone. So like that, it is impacting the fashion industry. Now, what has happened that people are not prioritizing fashion, as it is not falling in their essentials. So people do not know that what will happen, fashion is not in the front of their head. Okay, it is at the back of their head. So like they do not know what will this renovate again. Now, but I was talking about the Olympics logo, which was, now that also has been depicted by social distancing. Like people are coming up with all these things. So this is just to show you that how it has been impacted the world. Now, I was talking about the world fashion. Now, the impact of the Indian fashion industry also is also facing heat in this challenging time. Indian fashion industry is mainly based on the raw materials and the cheap labor, which has gone for a toss in this challenging times. Like the labors, you must be knowing, and raw materials also. Like I think you have heard about the textile factories and everything. So it has come to a standstill and it is not moving. Now, there are a lot of brands that are originated in India, be it related to fabric, that is Arvind, Raymond's, KG Denim, Mafatlal. There are a lot of brands which is Indian brands like Madura Brands, Louis Philippe, Allen Solly, Peter England, Van Heusen, Raymond's, Ginny Johnny also, Fab India, and Color Plus. So business is not happening and it is affecting them. One more thing was there that India is one of the big exporters for textile and garments. And as a world economy, it is hit in a big way. The challenging time will be there for a year or till the corona is not a day-to-day challenge. Lifestyle shoppers, I have already told you, these all are not working right now. They drive the fashion business in India. And standalone stores of different brands, that exclusive business outlet, multi-business outlets, nothing is working right now. So again, to show that the world economy is hit due to the lockdown imposed by different countries. So apart from the offline business, that is not going to start anytime soon. Online business also have took a big hit. And e-com portals like Myntra, Jabong, Flipkart, Amazon, Hopscotch, FirstCry, IGO has suffered big time. So not only the offline business, online business also is hit. Due to all this crisis, fashion industry has been forced to employ layoffs and salary cuts as they are not able to cope with the situation. So this is a very, very big point, and many of us are facing this heat. So I have heard from many of my friends that they are getting salary cuts or a certain amount of, I don't know about the teachers or there has been an impact. Now, in the last 5 years, there has been many startups who are also, they make fashion which is like on point, like Bewoof or a Soul Store. So now they are also facing the heat because there is no business rolling up. So overall, a void is created in the fashion industry. People's spending pattern has been changed big time, and that will have a lasting effect. So that was what is happening, and you must be knowing all these things, like what has happened. So it is impacting. So what next? What is the future of design and fashion industry? So I'll talk about the same now. So Shweta, is it okay till now?
Yeah, all good.
All good. Yeah.
And it's a lovely picture, by the way.
Yes, the girl is thinking that what will happen. She is like, she's having a rose and thinking
president,
that what
yeah.
will have.
Correct.
So before we start, let's check in the the below facts and little. So during the time of 2008-2009, there has been a great recession. Like the same, there was not a pandemic, but yeah, there was a hit in the fashion industry. There were layoffs. There were like job crisis. There were like salary cuts. And at that time also, many new things has happened. So just to give a glimpse of you that we should not let go the hope. So WhatsApp, which is a big platform, Uber, Pinterest, Airbnb, Slack, Venmo. So it was found during this time only. Now one more positive point I would like to talk about here is that that personal protective equipment PPE. So before the pandemic happened, we were like, I don't know what ranking was we were making or not, and how safe it was and all. But now in the last 2 years, we within a short time span, we are like the second largest manufacturer of PPE. So which is the big thing. So it can be said that in the past also and present also, people have turned challenges into opportunities, and it can't be denied that from these challenging times, the future of fashion industry can evolve, and certainly in a much better way than it was in the past. So we should not lose hope. In today's scenario, the world is looking up to India, like they are praising India for their lockdown strategies and everything, and the cases which could have been like 1,000 folds more is now a bit restricted. So, and India is supporting the, we read news and we come across that something good is India is doing. They are sending medicines. They are doing some business tie-ups also in this time. So people are looking up to India, and India is responding well internally and externally very positively. So what? So we should also think futuristic. This is an image which shows that the time has come that we have to think out of the box, new things, and why not? We can lead once again. So this is an image depicting the same. Okay. So that was the start. Now I'll go explain different points. How can we can evolve from this. So basically we have to redesign the fashion industry, and it can't be happen in one day. It has to be in a phased manner. We have to understand that how the government is opening in a phased manner this lockdown. The same thing will happen with the fashion industry. I'll explain this to you. So before jumping into the actual design and production, it is very important for the brands and designers to understand the pulse of the market and the customers. It's not like that what was happening earlier, the work should happen in the same way. We should analyze first. We should do a lot of research before jumping into design making. So there earlier, a brief was given, the designer was jumping into the designing, and the production was made. A lot of production was made, and people were not thinking about the, like if there was 50-60% clearance, it was thought to be a good design, but the situation will not be the same. So we have to go to more depth. We have to understand the scenario in a very technical way, and we have to look towards the perfection. Whatever we should make, we should be able to sell. And this should happen not only with the industry commercial designers, mass designers, but also with the dedicated designers also, like Sabri Shastri, or they should also think about the same, that they should understand the market. Even I have heard that Sabri Shastri also, I have told you about the weddings and everything, so they have also cut down to the scale what they were doing. So it should always happen that we should understand the market and then jump into the design. It's important to understand the human psychology. At the start, people will buy less and buy with what really matters. So I'm from a kidswear designing background, and I know that for a fact, people will buy for kids. So kidswear will be there. Like if a mother or father is there, they should not. Father will be the last person to buy for himself, and mother will be the second person. But they should buy. They will buy for the kids. So we should understand that what will sell, what will not sell, and accordingly we should make the thing. Due to all the factors mentioned as the current situation of fashion industry, it is understood that the people are choosing the functional over formal. So first, earlier the meeting, like if it, this meeting would have been in your college, Shweta, I would have come with a, you know, very formal suit and would have given a, you know, mind-blowing presentation over there. But it has changed to a very functional meeting. Okay. And that will be there. Like that will now... that will be the fashion forward. People will be more comfortable. So you can see that people are comfortable at, and active at home, and thus they want clothes which is casual and exercise ready. So they can work out also, like multi-purpose clothing they want to have rather than having a specific occasional clothing. The corona pandemic has also taught the people the importance of nature and saving the earth. And the same will reflect in the upcoming fashion in a direct or indirect way. So it will be there. So all these points, what I'm telling, it will be impacting fashion in the future. And sustainable fashion will play a very important role. I think that you must be knowing what is sustainable fashion, where we think about if you're making any product, we are using something that is not harming the earth, you know, that comes under the, you know, sustainable fashion criteria. Like we are making garments from recycled yarns or PET bottles. So those are the things where we are thinking about these things. So this will, you know, go to great extent. So we have to reduce, we have to reuse, we have to recycle, and we have to save that. So this is the, you know, thing that that will be there, and we have to think about the same in a way or two. Okay. So many brands that are doing exports will look into Indian market also to grow the business. Now, what I have told you all that we have different cities, like Delhi is known for their girls wear, you know, stuff, or you know, women's wear stuff, and they do a lot of export. Tirupur is known for their knitwear, and they do a lot of, you know, exports to top brands, Jacquardi and Ralph Lauren, and like what brands I have not mentioned over here, but top brands, the business is happening from the base of Tirupur, Ludhiana, Kolkata, Ahmedabad, Mumbai, and then Bangalore. So there are 6-7 hubs like which are doing a lot of exports, but the exporters will feel a heat now, because every across the world, across the globe, every country has been affected, and they have to look into their own things. They have to revive their own economy. So first they will not try to import from India or China. They will try to, you know, what Modi ji has told to India, that be, you know, vocal about local. So every country will be having the same strategies. So what will these export house do now? That is a big question, because their exports is going to be affected a lot. So they are thinking, you know, to look into the Indian market. They have to, you know, redesign stuff, you know, accordingly to the Indian clientele, and that also accordingly they are targeting. They have initiated the process also. They've initiated the process also, and they're looking into it that how, like earlier they used to export for Marvel or, you know, like Disney, but now they are thinking for the Indian clientele also, that how can they make things for the people over here. Many brands that are working with China will divert to India, as India is having great potential in raw materials and cheap labor. Now, what has happened to China? Like people were going there because of their export work policies and everything were more favorable than India. But what China has been hit back, and people are looking to India, and India with their open arms, they are thinking to make the policies very easy for doing trade. And what will happen that the India, like the southern Asia, like India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, we're doing a lot of fashion business, exports and everything. So that will get a boom just because the China, I told you that China was having like 40 or to 45% share of the fashion industry. Now that will be divided to all these countries like India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, and Philippines, and then up Bangladesh. Bangladesh is also becoming a very big hub. So that 45% share, if 15-20% share also comes to India, that will be a big booster. Now, what was happening that there were a lot of local domestic brands also, and high-end brands also, which were Indian brands, and they were doing a lot of sourcing from China, so and other countries. Now they will, as China thing happened, they will look into their own country and they will explore the possibilities over here. Hello, Shweta. Yeah, it's okay.
All good. All good.
Okay. So not only the brands outside India, but Indian brands also will look to invest in Indian raw materials only. Okay. Now the quality of goods was at par with standards, international standards, but the fashion industry of India still has a great opportunity to improvise itself. So why has China evolved in last 5 or 6 years? They have worked a lot on their quality. So earlier we used to say that it is made in China. I don't know how long it will sustain or everything, but they have improvised a lot. And if I compare our products with Chinese products, I will give a like hands up, a certain level of betterment to Chinese products only, not Indian products. So we have the opportunity to improvise our products, and product is the main thing which will drive the business. Okay, so there, as India, there will be a lot of competition within the brands who offer products in the same segment, but the pricing along with the quality will be a key factor deciding the products. So there are a lot of brands in the same segments. If I talk about women's wear, we have a lot of brands. Men's wear, we have a lot of brands. So now the pricing, quality, product, this will be the key in driving the business. Okay, one very important point people will look for lifestyle solutions. For example, they will want a complete set of they will want a complete solution. Like buying things for their newborns, so they will want that in a set. And if somebody is buying something for their girls, so they want some accessories along with it. So this is an important point because the designers have to think accordingly while designing only. So if a designer is making a dress, so he has to think about the additional accessories, what can be given with the garment as a giveaway, or they can charge a bit for the same. So these things will be there, and we have to think out of the box, as I said earlier. Now, this was even our government was very, they like, we are thinking about only fashion industry, but our government is thinking what will happen to the other industry also. So so you can see that PM Modi's vowels for new business and work culture, adaptability, we need to adapt business models, efficiency, that we should complete a task in the specified time frame. This is a very important point because every brand will be looking and making their guidance accordingly. inclusivity, to develop business model that care for vulnerable sections as well as our planet. I have already specified this point also. Opportunity, to evaluate new emerging opportunities, apply core capabilities, like opportunity, like what China will not have an opportunity and India will have an opportunity. Universalism. So, and whatever product we'll make, it will not be only, should be catering to India, but we should be having a global audience in mind. So that is universalism. So these are the vowels, and I found this slide very interesting. That's why I have shared with you all also. Maybe many of you must have gone through this slide. You must have looked into it. If not, but you can have a look. Okay. Now I'll talk more about what will happen to the e-commerce and online sales. So right now, people will not go to any malls. They will not go to any stores. They will prefer buying products from online. And online sales will have a boost because whatever they will want, they will get on online. And if I tell you that there are a lot of online portals like Myntra, Jabong, Flipkart, and they will try to give something exclusive. They will have that exclusivity in the mind. So this point, from this point, we can think that a lot of freelancing options for the designers will get into, because they will not keep the regular designers, but they will have some freelancing options, and they want to have some exclusive lines. And actually, they want to give a new thing every 1 month or 2 months to the audience. So that's why that exclusive line will be there. Now, as the online business will boom, the product shoot, the product description for e-com business, the promotions, the packaging will also play an important role in the selling of the products. This is a very, very important point for all the designers. First, once you design the product, generally they do not think about how will it get packaged. Okay, so you have to keep in mind the 360 degree vertical that, I just don't have to make a product. I have to sell it also. And what can I do? What extra I can do that will give it a boom to get it sold? So the everything designers should also look into not only the design perspective, but also the additional perspectives, which will drive the sales. Also, the brands will need to be flexible with the offers, and they will have to be on toes for different gimmicks for the sales. Now, what I mean to say that they have to do some gimmicks also, because if there is a lot of competition, and whoever is the is doing a different gimmick or making instant decision of if one style is not selling, like one style of top is not selling and one style of bottom is not selling, why not make it a combo pack and get it sold like that? Why not give it in a good packaging and get it sold like that? So all these things also, and that salespeople do not have their design ideas. So that for that, those design ideas, people will have to come back to the designers only, and designers have to keep their eye open. So I am emphasizing on all these points because we should not only look into only our job. We should also look into the multitasking, what we can do. Every brand, now I have told about the e-commerce portal. Now every brand will have to come up with a fast track range or a capsule collection to present something new every time and having an edge over the competition. So doing a mass production of 50 lakh, 5 million garments in a season, or they will come with the capsule collections. There the depth, garment depth will be there. Garment depth will reduce, and the width will increase, like the number of styles, number of options will increase. So obviously there will be a lot of work for the designers, because if they were making 500 designs earlier, they will have to make around 750 or 800 designs to cater the market, because everybody will look for more variety, and for that they will need more designs. The customization options will be offered by brands to build a good customer base. So basically what will happen that people will be open to customization. Like there can be some stylist, like fashion designer comes stylist also in the stores or online stores, who can suggest that this will look good, what will go where, or if anybody wants some customization on their garment, that they want some, like in a denim, they want some additional washing or something like that. So in any way, the objective is that whatever you will design, it should be sold. And for that, whatever the gimmick or the, you know, customization options, what we can offer, so that will be there. And I'm telling you that these are not the, you know, from the sales perspective, these are all points from the design perspective only. Because from the when we are making a garment, when we are thinking conceptualization a garment, then only we should keep everything in mind. Okay. Now this is one of the very important point. Every brand will have to come up with different product lines, keeping the different classes of society in mind. Their offering should have the economic range and also the premium products, that is hero, hub, hygiene products. So there is a pyramid, fashion pyramid, you can see, say that on the top, there is the hero, which belongs to the, you know, top upper class of the society. Hub is the, you know, the middle class or upper middle class, and hygiene products are for the, you know, lower class. So thinking about the same, any startup I'm doing or if I'm running a brand, I can't ignore that I have to do only make garments for only the top class people. That will not have that impact. So every brand have to come up with the ideas that how can we make garments for this economic segment also, and mid price point garments also. So they can do a bit of compromise with the quality in the hygiene products, but yeah, they will have to maintain the quality in the hero products. So this is the new beginning. What will they see? They have to, like, if I think of a brand like Tata. So Tata has Judio also. They have launched a new brand, Judio. You must, if you have not heard about the same, it is a very economic brand, and you can get you know, for men's, you can get a whole ensemble, like the top and bottom, within 1,000 rupees. So they have come with, they were having their best side brand. Now they have come with Judy also. So they before this pandemic only, they have like jumped in this point. So they have to cater to all the, you know, segments. Okay, so we'll go fast. Now this is the slide that Atmanirbhar. So why I want to showcase this slide is that our government is hopeful that we should move with confidence towards self-reliance and vocal for local. So time to become vocal about our local products and make them global. Economy, infrastructure, technology-driven systems, vibrant demography and demand are five pillars of Atmanirbhar Bharat. Bold reforms and a comprehensive package of 20 lakh crores they have, like, given. Now, if you will see, every state is want to reform their economic situation. Like Mr. Uddhav Thackeray, who is the chief minister in Maharashtra. So he is coming, he is saying that you come to us, we'll give you land, we'll give you opportunities, we'll give you labor. You come up with a plan and we'll be investing with you. Just that it should not harm the, you know, earth. So our textile business is one business which do not harm the earth and everything. So they are giving a lot of boost for economic revival. And there will be a lot of investment in this segment also. Now, some more points. I'll go fast a bit. India is rich in its heritage, crafts and fabrics. So now, as we have to be vocal about our local things, so these crafts will also get a boost in the future of our fashion industry. The artificial intelligence is coming into the picture in a big way. It's nothing but a tool that will tell the brands, e-com platform, etc., which is moving fast in the market, and thus their production can be planned accordingly. Like Amazon, they have already started working on this technology. That's what's hot and what is not. That means that they have a database. They are analyzing the sale of each and every product. Suppose a yellow jacket is moving very fast, so they automatically they will come to the brand or the designer, specific designer, that okay, your this jeans or this shirt or this dress is moving very fast, and they can come up with the thing that you need to make something like this more. Okay, so this artificial intelligence is coming in a big way, and brand will be investing in that. The designers need to have a 360 degree mindset. I have already told you about this, so that they not only make the products but also having suggestion by doing what the sales also can be enhanced. The designers and the brand need to reframe the design process and need to standardize. Now, this is a very important point, standardization. So what will happen that we have to come up with a lot of new things every 2 months. We can't keep on changing the things, like we can't change the tone of red or different fabrics. We have to do something standard, because that will help the production thing also. So that is the thing that we should take care, that if a brand is there, we should have some at least 60% things which is standard, so that it boosts the production cycle also. So in this way, fashion will be evolved, can make a huge so in this way the fashion industry can make a huge impact in the coming time. The use of technology will be very important. So these, I heard from Shweta that a lot of students are there, and this slide is for them only. But wait. I want the students to read the content of this slide. That future of the fashion industry is having high hopes from the younger generation. They are very idealistic and creative. They have the impeccable talent to understand what is need of that, and accordingly they can. They can make any garment a hero product. They with their talent can be a young entrepreneur, can have their startups, and can be the driving force of any brand. Collectively, they can drive the world's expectations. So this is the line I want to dedicate to all the students, because I know people, like if I would have also been a student, I would have been thinking that what will happen to the future, how will it, how will their future will be. But it's not the time to get demoralized. It's not the time to think that that we already have evolved. It's just a break that has happened since last 3-4 months, but it will not apply the brakes on our brain. Like we will keep thinking, we will keep evolving. There are a lot of setups that are happening. Every brand is thinking about their how to evolve the economy and everything. So yeah, it is a challenging time, but I think that I have given you enough inputs that how we can get evolved from this situation. Okay, so this is thank you from my side.
It was wonderful, Saurabh. It was insightful indeed. And this was well said. There has been a break on our run probably, but there's no break on the brains. That is something which I really liked. I think our students will have good input from here. So Saurabh, just let's take up some questions from attendees.
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah, you can also refer to the question answer box. The questions are there. But the first question which I have is, so which garment segment do you think will flourish now? Okay, so
what do you mean by
like you mentioned, obviously people will not stop buying for kids. Then yeah. Smart casual, as you mentioned, we may not be wearing too much garments, but yes, moth. Yeah, so segments.
Athleisure will be in demand right now. So people will be having the, like I've said, that whatever people will wear it, they want to have, they want to do multitasking in that garment only. So they will come up, this athleisure thing will be there in the trend going ahead. You can run into it, you can have a presentation into it. So that is the thing. Yeah. And obviously, I would like to say that kidswear will be there. Kidswear ka demand will be more initially. the economic things like packs, pack of twos, pack of threes, those type of products will be initially that will be there. But after that, yeah, it will come back to normal, but it will take some time. Yes.
Okay.
One more thing. Masks.
Yeah.
Masks exactly, that will yeah. be there for another 2 years. So if you're designing a dress, make a mask with it. If you're designing a shirt, make a mask with it. Give it as a giveaway. So that will be there.
Yeah. So be fashionable in whatever you wear.
Yeah.
Okay, so the second question is it worth going abroad for fashion related or work or entrepreneurship in this present era? Do you feel so?
No, not advisable right now. Look, one thing I would like to share that, see, what is happening in US right now, we are able to scroll that in our mobile. The next second. So whatever is a new thing is happening in the world that is coming to in our mobile or on the news. So we have to get inspired from that. Not you have to physically go there and invite that virus that come back to India. So we have not to do that. We can keep our brains running. Mind running, and from there, like we can take the ideas and invest in our local things.
Yeah, and as PM Modi ji has already mentioned, go local. So I think the best time not to go out and do something here for.
And not you be in at your home only. Be safe.
Exactly.
Don't wander also. Exactly. Yeah. Next question, please.
Yeah. With the rise of budget cuts and layoffs, what are the job opportunities present for us as fashion students?
So fashion students, so you have to explore a lot of things. You learn the styling thing. Okay, you develop some habits. You go in depth in some other design areas. You can learn a bit of merchandising. You can learn a bit of sample production. Okay, you can, like if you are a design student, There are a lot of things to explore in that criteria only. You can learn a lot. You can explore a lot of things, like what is the new washing trends. You can learn, and that, like if I'm a denim designer and I'm an expert in doing a lot of washes in the garments, like the denim X wash or stone wash, and I can take that input from denims to t-shirts. Why not? So that you have to explore. That mindset you have to keep open. You have to have a 360 degree perspective that, okay, whatever work will be given to you, you will not say no initially like that. Yeah. Next question, please.
There's a related question. So as a designer, do you think you have the same freedom to express post-COVID era, since people will be spending more on necessities now and less on fashion? So how do you suggest, what do you suggest to designers to cope with this?
Okay, I'll give you one example. Okay, so if a new garment is made in like Tommy Hilfiger, okay, so you can, if you'll go to a local shop also, now you can find that garment. Okay, so fashion, if you'll see that, it's not only based on the, top level. And many top level fashion is inspired from the street design only. So what I will like to tell you, that it's not, you are thinking that, what was the question, Shweta? Can you repeat that one second?
So how do you think designer would cope up from this? Like will they have the same freedom to express?
Yeah, they will have more freedom because they have to, come up with new ideas. And they have to, when you are coming up with new ideas, you are going to explore more.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Actually, yeah, it's going to be more challenging for them. I think it's better they go get now.
Ha, okay. Abhi tak to life was easy. Abhi samajh mein aayega.
Now there's this big leaking question. As many countries are boycotting China, it is a great time for India to emerge and set up industries, right?
Yes.
Why are we not thinking on these lines and at least planning for this? Because it is a good time to think of new ideas and do rigorous planning.
Achha, can you tell me that this question, who has asked this question?
Supreeta Jha. Supreeta, yeah.
Is she a student?
She's a student, yeah.
Okay. So in my whole PPT, I was talking about that there are a lot of brain investment also, mind work also, legwork also happening that they will be happening, like people are investing in India rather than China. So might be, I must be, you know, I'm not able to communicate to her properly. But yeah, India, everybody is thinking that, yeah, there will be a boost and we are working on that direction.
No, exactly. And even I am like, if you start reading news around, everybody who's related to this business is there on the toes. Everybody's thinking about it. It's not that we are not thinking. It's just mm-hmm. that this will come later.
Yes.
So the next question is from Deepa. She says, how can you identify a good brand? Like if you have a new brand, how do you identify it's good or not?
Okay. I have told you about this the same. You should always look about the quality of products rather than the pricing and everything. So quality, like if I'm a kidswear, I belong to a kidswear industry. So I will try to answer from that angle. So if I'll buy anything for my daughter and she rejects it after wearing once, she'll say that, Papa, it's itching. I'm not feeling comfortable. I'm sweating. So that brand is not a good brand for me, which is not taking care of the quality of the products. So basically, you should look up to the quality. Now, there are a lot of technical things. Again, I think this question will be from an NAE student.
Not mentioned. She hasn't mentioned.
Okay. So what will happen that there are a lot of technical things that is happening. Like if I talk about polyester, so there are two types of polyester mainly. One is the spun poly and one is the filament poly. So filament poly is not a good polyester to use for the garments, but many brands are using that, and which is giving you a lot of, you know, I have told about the itching and sweating and everything. But spun polyester is as good as the cotton thing. So quality, whoever will maintain the quality will succeed. Because if you think that this is a good brand, I will buy from it, and you go and buy the product, one time will wear it and second time will not wear it, and you will advise that udhar se mat lena, it is not a good product. So exactly. Yeah, next question please.
Do you think people will purchase apparels according to seasons after this pandemic?
India was never purchasing apparels keeping in mind the season. Okay. Yeah, obviously there were some people were in specific, that will be very need specific, that whatever is, if there is cold, they will want to have a jacket. If somebody is feeling hot, they will, irrespective of the weather temperature, if Shweta, hello.
Okay, I think I lost connection. All right.
No.
So yeah, the next question is, again, I think they have answered this. Fashion job opportunities for students post pandemic. I think they have answered this. Okay. The next is, what is the difference between virtual and augmented reality, and what is the future of both?
See, I am not a very technical person. Okay. I won't be able to answer that. What is the difference between the augmented reality and virtual reality? I think the augmented reality is more technical. Virtually, it's what we are doing right now. It is a virtual connection that I can see right now Shweta only, and I am able to tell whatever to all of you. So that is the virtual reality. Augmented will be more technical. It is more towards the technical things, and I don't know how to relate that with design right now. But yeah, whoever this student is, I would like to come back to him for this answer.
Cool. Okay, so do you think there'll be any effect of corona pandemic on the prices of the products?
Yeah, for sure. At the beginning, for sure. That I have told you, that Hero, Hub, Hygiene, that every brand has to, think about that economic thing. Every brand has to make something to, that pack of twos, pack of threes, like, you give more value in a limited, in an economic price. So that will be there.
We also had a question from somebody I just missed, that what is the difference, what is the meaning of Hero and Hub product that you mentioned in your
white? So just after the session, you go to Google, you write Hero, Hub and Hygiene. Okay, I will tell you that is a pyramid. okay, you'll see a pyramid. So the base of the pyramid is like the width is zyada, more, okay, and the top is, you know, like this. So hero belongs, like if we have 100% people, the hero is only 10% because of this shape. Okay, if you divide a triangle into three equal parts, so only the top part is hero, which is around 10%. The hub is, you know, 40% or 35%, and next 55% is the hygiene, you know, the ready, the day-to-day wear and everything. So that is the thing. You can explore that in Google also. That is very well depicted over there. Yes.
Okay, so there's another anonymous question. Person asked that, do you think a designer is more hands-on with the present situation or the salesperson who's actually involved with customers and the real-time feedbacks? Whom do you think...
Sales team pe jo pressure, I and Abhi, what designer, we can't even imagine also. Because exactly. They have to deliver. The design responsibility is like when they submit a design, then they submit a design, their responsibility is over. But sales plan has to, you know, sell the product. And in this challenging time when there is no open, like no malls open, no offers are going on, people are there, no footfalls in the, you know, everywhere, anywhere. E-com business, like if you talk about the e-com business also, if they are making one thing, they are coming into, you know, making something different, which was not from their line. So right now it's all about the survival thing. Okay. So yeah, if you are a designer, we are into more comfortable, you know. So sales wala job is, you know, very field oriented. So that they obviously they have to, we are in a very comfortable job. This way, the next question.
But I think as per my industry experience goes, I think all designers and merchandisers and salespeople, we have this close connection. We keep discussing and change ideas.
Take this question and give an answer. I've told you that every designer have to be a salesperson right now because that is the need of that.
Exactly.
So I think
that's a correct answer because even a designer has to think from the sales point of view. Right.
Yeah.
Correct. Correct. Okay. I think Mr. Naman has liked your Modi ji's slide too much. So he says, can you please elaborate the Modi slide once again in the end?
Which Modi slide? I have like shared two slides.
I think where you've mentioned all 5 points is what I'm guessing.
Okay. It is very, you can go into on any my government site and you can have those points. But yeah.
Mm.
So actually vowels like A-E-I-O-U to start with. He has a PM Modi's vowels for a new business and work culture post COVID-19. Adaptability, adaptable business models. Like according to what India will be taking care, enhancing the digital things also. Efficiency, like emphasis should be on completing a task in the specified time frame. So we have to be efficient. We can't have like that attitude that, okay, aaj nahi to kal, that we can't. Inclusivity, to develop business models that care for vulnerable sections as well as our planet. I think these are self-explanatory. You want
yeah,
to
exactly. To yeah, yeah. That's
opportunity. Fine. But I'll read it for them. For them. Opportunity to evaluate new emerging opportunities, apply core capabilities, and universalism. Not only vocal for local. Yeah, be vocal correct. For local, go global.
Yes, correct. Okay.
Yeah.
And yeah, it was not Mr. Naman, it was Miss Namana. She just told me.
Okay.
All right. So what do you advise for those who are willing to start their own brand? Is this a favorable time?
Why not? Mm-hmm. I have told you that when the recession of 2008-2009 happened, at that time, the technology was not that great. Mm-hmm. Okay. The technology is now evolving with each passing day. So when at that time, they can think of something of, you know, WhatsApp, Uber, Airbnb, which is like, if you see their valuation, you will be like surprised. So why not? We can also just think of a good idea and explore.
And our former president, Mr. APJ Abdul Kalam also mentioned, I just remember that every time is the best time. You just need to see what the situation was and just explore on.
Yeah. Yes. So it's never too late. you can start now, you can have good opportunities now. It's not like that. In the initial stage, you have to keep the scenario of the market into your mind. But yeah, why not? You can explore a lot of things and you can do a lot of startups. Yeah.
So, sir, do you think now e-commerce is getting much more importance than offline marketing? So what do you think independent brands will be able to survive?
So they will come on onto the online platforms. They will tie up with all the online things. So they will come with, they will come up with, they will have some, like Ginny Johnny will do a tie up with Myntra. Ginny Johnny products exclusive for Myntra. Ginny Johnny products exclusive for Jabong. Yes. And they will come up with their own apps also. Because it, if they have to be in this their business, like if I'm a parent and I want to, shop only for my kid and I like Ginny and Johnny clothing. Or if I'm a I like US Polo for that matter, or I like Tommy. So why should I waste time going to Flipkart, Myntra, Jabong? Why should not I just go to their own app and explore products for me? So they have to come up with their own apps also.
Exactly.
They have to be in their online business. They have to be there in B2C category business. Like, okay, next question, please.
What is the most good subject to explore under fashion? Subjects under fashion,
okay, so whoever has asked this question, can she or he like tell me about what what is the course she is having, like textile she is having, fashion she is having, whatever, like
very difficult to get it.
It's difficult to get.
Anyways, but you can explore in any subject. Every subject, like if you want to explore in fabrics, you can have a lot of knowledge in fabrics. If you want to do in graphics, so there is a scope in every department. It's not like that you have to think about only one thing. You can do in graphics, you can do in designing, you can do in designing. There are different verticals you can do for menswear, womenswear, kidswear. Then you can do economic designing. You can be like. Anything, like, so that is huge. You just think about one subject and you can explore a lot of opportunities in that one.
There's one related question. Is fashion technology a good route for designer?
Fashion technology is the base of designing. Okay, the designers do not know how the garments are being stitched, they are being made. They do not understand the technicalities of the garment. They will make anything. But a fashion technical, person can tell the designer that whatever you have made is not correct. He has that much power. That, okay, you have made something, which is not suitable for this type of design. So, yeah, that part is also, as Shweta, you have also done merchandising. You must be knowing what I'm talking
exactly,
about.
Exactly. Yeah. Completely. And also for students, I think it all depends on your mind inclination. So you have to actually find out all these points and see wherein you see your inclination going towards. Okay, one question. So what can Indian medical textile demand from us regarding new innovations?
So you have seen that I have told you in one of my points that India was not able to make the PPE. PPE we were not able to make and we have to import a lot of from other countries. Now we are making that. So medical, the real heroes are not the Avengers or, they are the medical people who are taking care of us right now. So whatever thing we can do for them will be a great boost for them because we have not thought on those lines. So I will try to congratulate whoever have asked this question because that is a salute for all of us to this medical, fraternity that, we should look into that. We can come up with the next level of what can be the PPE, what is the next level of PPE, how can, and once this pandemic has started, nobody knows that anything can happen anytime. Like the next pandemic can be around the corner. So why not be prepared from right now? Okay. So I think that answers your question. Now next question.
Yes. Shweta, one minute. To
yes,
support Saurabh's comment on medical textiles. For the information of all the members here, I will tell you the efforts made by the Government of India to develop PPE in terms of cost wise. The difference is from if you want to get a set of PPE from China, it is almost $22 plus the transport and charge of $8 to $10. That is the cost. But fortunately, because of the initiation of the Government of India, Indian manufacturers are supplying PPE at a cost of 650 rupees.
Wow.
It is hardly not even the $8.
Yes.
Everybody just do a thumbs up. Everybody just do a thumbs up. Yeah. To you know, show our gratitude to all these people.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yes.
Correct. Okay. So we'll take up the last question for the session today. How the startup in traditional industry like handlooms should come up with the help of Government of India, and which segment should they focus? So basically,
India is a hub of you know all these handlooms and everything. Okay. I was just surfing to the news and I have come across one very good news that people have made masks from khadis, which is a pure handloom thing. Okay. So if they are coming up with these ideas and you see, you go, if you have a, you know, specified craft that is origin of that state, like you, there are so many crafts, like, you know, Banarsis or like Ikats or whatever. So you can, and government is telling us that they will be more vocal about the local. So they will be investing in uplifting this craftsmanship. Okay, what used to happen that the craftsmen were not getting good payment. And there were middlemen who were getting the all the you know opportunities and flourishing all these things. But now it will come to the root level, and it will give them a good opportunity. So which will take our India really really ahead.
Exactly. So I think there is no limit of possibilities. Sky is the limit. So keep exploring.
Yeah.
So I think it was a wonderful session, quite insightful. I think and it was very simple. It was in a very, it was flowing like a river. So step by step, I think students and all academicians and industrialists who were with us, I think they've got a very good insight. I express appreciation for your inspiring presentation, Saurabh. I think your approach to anticipating users' intent was really commendable.
Thank you, Shraddha.
My
and guys, pleasure. Once again, Eid Mubarak and be safe, be at home.
Yeah. Okay. Exactly.
And only let your mind explore all the opportunities outside.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah.
Thank you for sparing your time and connecting with us, Saurabh, and sharing your thoughts.
And thank you, Shraddha. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Saurabh.
Thank you.
Thank you, all the participants. We hope you enjoyed our today's session. I believe we were able to solve all your queries. I think we tried taking up maximum of the questions, keeping ourselves into the constraints of timelines. And please do keep attending the next session that we have on 27th. It's sustainable fashion. Please be with us and let's meet all of you. And Saurabh, you also tune in for the next session for us.
Thank you. Thank you. We'll do the same.
Thank you all, guys. Thanks. Please keep tuning in. Let's keep seeing. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day and happy Eid to all once again. Thank you.
Okay.